Hi everyone! Many of you have definitely heard about predator plants. Those who hear about them for the first time will probably say that it's just another stupid joke. But dear friends, we're not kidding you, they really exist. According to various reports, there are more than 600 species of predatory plants. And it's not because life is a bed of roses. These plants have evolved this way because they live in a habitat with not enough nutrients. Therefore, they have to hunt in order to compensate the lack of energy. They receive missing elements from caught insects and other small animals, and each plant uses its own cunning traps to catch unsuspecting victims. So today, we will tell you about the most popular bloodthirsty carnivorous plants and the way they hunt. Let's get it on. Sarracenia. This bright insectivorous plant, also known as the trumpet pitcher, belongs to the Sarraceniae family and lives in the marshes of North America and the southeastern parts of South America. Sarracenia has bright flowers and bright green leaves decorated with crimson capillary lines. Its leaves resemble envelopes and exude sweet juice. Once the insect has fallen into the trap, it's doomed. The leaves of the plant are covered with hairs, which allow insects to move only in one direction. Cunning, isn't it? By means of evolution, the leaves turned into a funnel with a lump resembling a hood that prevents rainwater from entering the plant. Thanks to this, the digestive juices of the Sarracenia are not diluted and have a super strong digestion force. Once trapped, insects simply dissolve in these juices, providing the plant with nitrogen, calcium, magnesium, and other nutrients. Nepenthes. Nepenthe, or tropical pitcher plant, is a carnivorous plant that inhabits the tropical forests of China, Malaysia, Indonesia, and the Philippines. It grows mainly as a liana, but among the 80 species of this plant there are also shrubs. It owes its name to the special form of its leaves that remind a pitcher. It also has another funny name, monkey cup, because researchers noticed that monkeys often drank rainwater from it. The pitchers of these plants are large enough to catch frogs, rodents, and even small birds. However, Nepenthe mainly prefers insects. On the inside of the pitcher walls, there are glands that produce nectar and wax. The nectar lures the prey, while the smooth wax prevents it from escaping, so the poor victim drowns inside the pitcher. Byblis. Our next green predator is the handsome Byblis. This low shrub inhabits northern Australia, the south of New Guinea, as well as some parts of Western Australia. It's also known as the rainbow plant for the flashy appearance of their mucilage-covered leaves on a sunny day. The branches of the rainbow plant are littered with narrow, long leaves, on the surface of which there are setae and glands, which release a strong adhesive substance and digestive enzyme. Both insects and small animals fall into this trap. The Australian Aborigines once believed that the Byblis could even catch and digest a person, but even after this horror story, they were not afraid to use its leaves as a source of glue. Genlicea. Genlicea usually grows in humid, terrestrial, and semi-aquatic environments, is widespread in Africa, Central, and South America. Genlicea is a small grass with yellow flowers, which hunts using a trap similar to a crab claw. It's easy to fall into such traps, but it's impossible to get out from them because of the small hairs that grow only in one direction. These plants have two different types of leaves, one above the ground to breathe and special underground leaves that entice, trap, and digest small organisms. Underground leaves also serve as roots, absorbing water and attaching the plant to the ground, since the plant doesn't have proper roots. These unusual leaves under the ground form empty tubes which look like a spiral. Microbes and small organisms get into them along with a stream of water, but they cannot get out from them. They may only get to the exit in the form of remnants, because by that time they've already been digested. Darlingtonia. Darlingtonia californica is considered a fairly rare plant. This is the only specimen of the Darlingtonia genus that grows in Northern California and Oregon. This plant loves swampy terrains, but looks like a cobra ready to throw itself at you. Because of its pitchers that resemble the hood of a snake, it's often called the cobra plant or the cobra lily. This is quite an insidious plant. It not only entices insects with a sweet aroma into its jug, but also has numerous false exits directed downwards on its walls that don't allow the victim to get out. Utricularia. Utricularia, also known as bladderwort, is a predator plant found in standing water. The bladderwort genus contains 220 widely distributed species. It doesn't have any roots, and so it hunts insects and small crustaceans to survive. This is the only predatory plant that uses a bubble trap. The bubbles are under the water along with the leaves, and on the surface there are only flowers. Most species have very small traps in which they can catch only small prey, such as protozoans. The bubbles have an entrance, which opens when an insect is near. The signal for the opening of the bubble comes from a set of trigger hairs located next to the entrance. When an insect touches a hair, the bubble opens and pulls the prey along with the water, and starts digesting it. Drosera. This European insectivorous plant is known as Drosera, or the sundew. There are about 130 species of this plant known to science. In the summer, blooming sundew can be recognized thanks to its small white flowers, growing on long flower stalks. But for the most part, it's an inconspicuous insectivorous grass, with hairy leaves lying on the ground. The liquid released by the hairs is very similar to dew, but in reality, it's glue, deadly dangerous for insects, as well as an enzyme for digesting the prey. The victim, attracted by the smell of this pseudo-dew, sits down on a leaf and, game over, it's glued. The hairs hold the unfortunate creature on the surface of the leaf. The enzyme begins dissolving the food and the leaf, meanwhile folds, depriving the prisoner of a last chance for salvation. Not digested remains fall to the ground, after which the leaves take their usual form. The hairs are covered with beads of sticky dew, and a new hunt begins. Some very large species of sundew can catch even unwary little frogs and small birds. Pinguicula. The places similar to the sundew habitat, you can meet another green predator, butterworts, or Pinguicula. In appearance, it's a rosette of large leaves tapering at the end, and covered with a glossy, glue-like, greasy mass. When blooming, a stem with a purple flower grows from the center of the rosette. The hunting process and the nutrition is similar to the one of the sundew. Insects attracted by the smell of fat stick to the leaf, which is wrapped inwards, and digestive secretions dissolve the prey. The obtained minerals and vitamins are absorbed by the plant, and then the leaf unfolds and waits for new guests. There are approximately 80 species of these plants in America, Europe, and Asia. Aldrovanda vesiculosa. This is undoubtedly a magnificent rootless carnivorous aquatic plant. Usually it eats small water vertebrates using a trap. The plant consists mainly of free-floating stems, which reach 6 to 11 centimeters in length. Leaves traps with a size of 2 to 3 millimeters grow in 5 to 9 curls in the center of the stem. The traps are attached to the air chamber of the stem, which allows the plant to float. This is a fast-growing plant. It can grow up to 9 millimeters per day, and in some cases produce a new curl over the same period of time. While the plant blooms at one end, the other gradually dies. The trap of the plant consists of two parts, which slam shut like a steel trap. Whole traps are directed outward and covered with thin hairs that allow it to close around any victim that's close enough. Can you imagine? The trap shuts down in just a few milliseconds, and it's just a plant. Dionaea muscipula. The Venus flytrap, or Dionaea muscipula, is the only predatory plant that catches insects in a way that anyone can notice without using special equipment. Its leaves look like the mouth of a mysterious monster. When the leaf slams shut, the prey can no longer get out of it. This plant seems to have its own mind, because it can tell the difference between a living creature and something else. When the leaf closes idle or something inedible enters it, it will open itself within half an hour. If an insect is caught, the trap remains closed for several weeks until the food is completely digested. This green monster grows in the humid, temperate climate on the Atlantic coast of the United States. And by the way, this wonder plant can be purchased in many flower shops. So if you wish to decorate your house and at the same time get rid of any annoying insect, this mini predator is the right thing for you. Amazing gadgets, upcoming technologies, incredible inventions, and other cool stuff related to high tech on TechZone. Subscribe, you won't regret it. The link is on the screen and in the description.
Thanks for watching.
Please like and share the video in social networks, and we'll be right back to you as fast as we can.